Hi all, let's discuss about how does JavaScript memory management works. So the term memory management, if you get the term of memory management, we need to deal with two things, like how does the memory is allocated and how does we are going to release the memory. So we are going to see that. So in a memory lifecycle, we have three things, three parts to be discussed. Number one is how, if we declare any variables, how we are going to allocate the memory. And number second part is using that memory for our business logic. And the third part is whenever we are no longer needed those variables or objects, we need to release that memory. So these are the three phases of a memory lifecycle. So the first phase is allocation and the last phase is releasing the memory. Both the first and third phases are handled by JavaScript engine. So allocating and garbage collection, releasing the memory, are handled by JavaScript engine. So now what is necessary for us to learn then? So it is automatically handled by JavaScript. So what's the need for us to learn this? In sense, it's very good to learn this part because if we understand how the JavaScript engine allocates the memory, we can use the memory in an optimal way. And also if we understand how the JavaScript engine runs the garbage collection algorithm, then we can sort out some of the memory leakages. So this is the reason we need to understand this topic well. So going into the topic, so JavaScript engine allocates, there will be two types of storages for JavaScript engine. It uses stack and heap. So this is called as a stack. So in the stack is a static memory allocation. All the primitive types would be stored in the stack. For example, numbers, booleans, undefines, and nulls. So these are the primitive types, though all these would be stored in the stack. It means primitive types means at that compile time only, we would be knowing the size of these primitive type values. So those would be stored in the stack. Stack is a data structure where it will be storing the data first come and last out, first in, last out basics. So this is a type of memory allocation. So here we need to understand a point, like we need to define the variables. Like if we declare a variable var is a function level scope. If I declare a var at the function level, so the memory is allocated throughout the function. The var variable would be resided, it would be stayed in the stack for throughout the function. So which is not the correct way to use the variables memory. So this is the reason we need to use let and constant, because those are block level scope. Anywhere we wanted to use any variable, use that in a block. And once the block is completed, that variables would be released from this stack. So this is the reason we need to understand the memory so that we can use variables in an optimal way. We would be using more blocks and lets and constants, making our scope very limited so that the memory allocation would be very optimal. So this is the one way of allocating the memory stack. The second one would be heap. Coming to objects, functions and arrays, all these three are dynamic allocation of memory. So their size could not be determined at the compile time. At the runtime, we can determine those size of these objects, arrays and functions. So all heap is a full length of memory. So if you observe here, the person is an object, so it would be stored in the heap and its reference would be stored in the person here. You can see, let me take a pointer to point it. Yep. So we have a person here. We have created a person object. That person object would be resided in the heap and we'll be pointing that reference in the stack. We discussed stack would be holding all the primitive types and also the references. So the reference to this object would be present in the stack. So later on we have dog object and a function. All these things also would be going into the heap memory, and those references would be pointing in the stack. In the last line, if you observe person is an object, we are assigning that to a new reference. It means we have a new person object pointing to the same new person reference pointing to the same object. It means two references for the same object. So this is how the heap works. Exactly, the memory allocation, the dynamic memory allocations would be allocated in the heap and those references would be stored in the stack. So this is all about the memory allocation. If you understand this while writing the code, you can make the right decisions. So in order to remove an object, in order to assign references to the same object, so that you are not going to recreate an object and memory in the heap. So this is how the memory allocation works. Now we need to discuss how the garbage collection works. It means garbage collection means we need to remove the memory from the heap, which we are not going to use. No longer used objects and functions would be removed from the heap. So let's discuss here. We need to have a few algorithms to remove this garbage collection. So the first algorithm is reference counting garbage collection algorithm. What does this algorithm does? So we have an object person, and in that person object, we have hobbies. So in sense, this is a person object and this is a hobbies array. Arrays are also an objects in JavaScript. So this person object is pointing to hobbies here. And later on we have person is assigned to a new reference. So we have two references, person and new persons, pointing to this person object in the heap. Later on we are pointing hobbies array to a hobbies pointer. So this reference, hobbies reference, is pointing to this hobbies array. Now we are going to make forcefully this nulls. I mean, we are removing this references. So in fact, in the code, after once we are using this person object, we can make them null. So in that case, this referencing reference counting algorithm, it will try to count the reference. If it will pick an object in the heap, it will check whether it has any reference it is pointing to. So if no references are pointed, it will remove those objects from the heap. So this is how the reference counting algorithm works. So we have a problem here. And also the object array is not deleted because hobbies are pointing to this hobbies array. So this is the reason this array is not deleted. Only this person object is deleted and hobbies is pointing to hobbies. So it would be there in the heap itself. So this is how the reference counting algorithm works. But there is a problem here, like a circular reference problem. For example, I have an object son and also have an object dad. So for son.dad property, I am assigning dad object, and dad.son property, I am assigning son object. It means I'm trying to forcefully creating a circular reference problem here. And once the usage was done, I'm assigning nulls here. So if you observe, no pointer is pointing to the objects here from stack to the heap. We have declared null. But these objects present in the heap, those are pointing each other. Here the reference counting algorithm doesn't work because it will try to release these objects. It will come here and it will try to release the object, but it identifies this object is pointing to someone. It means someone is pointing to this son object, and it will go to the dad object and it will identify dad object is pointing by son. So it will not release these objects forever. So this is known as a circular reference problem. So to avoid this problem, we have one more algorithm. And this is a constant. And from 2012, we have this algorithm, that is mark and sweep algorithm, a promising algorithm in releasing the memory. It works in the same way for the referencing algorithm, but unlike, it will also solve the cyclic problem. How does it will solve the cyclic problem? In sense, for browsers, we have roots. In sense, objects. Window object is a root for the browser. So this window object would be attached to the objects. So now window dot person, it will refer to all the objects and references present in the stack. And thereby from there, it will refer to its internal objects, unless until it finds an object which is unreachable. So in the earlier object, the garbage collection is like if an object is no more needed, it would be removed. Here in this algorithm, if an object is no more reachable, if an object is unreachable, then that object would be released. Then that object would be released. It means window is attached to the person all the references would be attached to the global object window. From window, it would be traced out to the lower levels. So it goes to the person first, and from person is pointing to something, and from there it is pointing to some other objects. So window will not remove or any, all these objects are reachable from any from person object through window. Now these objects which are present in the garbage red color, these objects are not reachable from this window. So these are considered as a unreachable objects, and those are marked and swiped after some time. So these garbage collection algorithms will work periodically for some time, and those would be marked, all the unreachable objects would be marked, and after some time it would be removed. So this is how all the memory allocation works and the garbage collection algorithm works. Also, there would be some leakages, memory leakages, like we have observed a window reaches all these mark and sweep algorithm works with the roots, I mean window object. For these reasons only, we'll be saying that don't use anything directly to the window object. If we use something like this, so if I use users directly like this, and get users, I call some variable or function an object, I would be allocating a memory here. I would be allocating memory here. So now what happens? So now I'm not going to remove this memory in program, my program forcefully. So window.users, whenever it tries to do windows.users, this object would be reachable at any point of time. So that is the reason it will not remove this memory, because this object is reachable from this users. So this memory is not removed. So this is a memory leakage example. So this is the reason if we ask not to use variables at the global level. Those causes the memory leakages. Once, if you want to use these type of variables, please make sure to use users.null. I mean, forcefully make this reference to null, so that window can know it can't reach to the object where it needs to reach. So if you want, don't use this type of variables. If you're trying to use, it would be like a memory leakage. So if you want to use this, try to use this also. Users is equal to null. Make this reference null at the end after your usage. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe.